Welcome to Aruba. We are flying today in the Britten Norman Islander from Anguilla Air Services. Victor Papa Alpha Alpha Charlie. Rolls right off the tongue, doesn't it? And we're going to be flying today from Aruba to Bonaire, overflying Curacao. Let's turn on the external power supply. Mixtures are rich. Let's go props full forward. Master and battery switches on. Fuel pumps on. Fuel valves open. Rotating beacon on. Open the starter hood. Let's put the mags on. Quick look to the starboard engine, make sure we're not going to kill anybody. And I didn't open the throttles like I should have, but the starter engine is fine. Oil pressure is good, it's really the only one we're worried about. Right on start. Port engine is clear. Pressure looking good there. Alright, let's turn pumps off. Check fuel pressures. Fuel pressure looking good. Make sure we look at taxi. Let's turn the avionics passing switches on. Let's lean here for taxi left. Or excuse me, pull the throttle back a little bit. We're on the ramp here. We make basically a 180-degree turn in throttle. Actually, I think we pretty much go straight ahead on kilo. First of all, we put in radio frequency 122.8. That is the common traffic. Switch that. Let's also put in 112.5, the nav frequency, because we want to use nav radio today. Just for kicks, a heading of 100, nav 1. You may wonder why, those of you who know what I'm doing, which is VOR navigation, and are wondering why are you doing it? This is really not necessary, and it's not super common anymore. Nav strobe lights on, taxi light on. Let's turn the external power supply off. I just like doing it. I like using VORs. Just trying to get myself comfortable here to see if it's engaged the brakes. Release the parking brake and broadcast our intentions here. Our intentions. Aruba traffic and Lila 264 taxiing to runway 11 for departure via Kilo Charlie Aruba. Alright, so brakes are released. Here, let's test the brakes. Brakes are working just fine. Low bus. We're back taxi here to Charlie. Or not back taxi, but taxi to Charlie. Give us a little bit more. Charlie here. Make what is called an intersection departure, which means you're departing from an intersection with the runway. You're not departing from the full length of the runway. And let's hold short here. I don't think we really have to, but set the airplane up for takeoff, put down the first notch of the flaps, the takeoff flaps, let's turn the fuel pumps back on, mixture is rich, props are pulled forward, I don't think I'm sure traffic set up on my iPad, make sure there's nobody. There's somebody coming in possibly. Aruba traffic, Aguila 264, taking runway 11 for departure from taxiway Charlie, Aruba. There's a JetBlue plane coming in here. I don't see anybody on the runway, except for that truck, because our left here. Runway 11. I will check properly for the heading indicator. Put ourselves on the center line. Let's bring in the power. Take off the power to set mixture props full forward. All the engine suites are in. Basically, what we're doing is going to this view. got running at what, about 16 gallons per hour per side, 30 gallons per hour for about 1 year of spec. Now what we're gonna do is trim. Oh, excuse me. Back up, red light, levers. I always want to see a beam. airplanes. This was how you navigated, either by looking out the window or the door. Radio frequencies. So this is leg two of our Caribbean tour. Some white caps today. Amount of wind. Seas are up a little bit today. So basically what I'm doing is reflying a trip that I took in Cessna 152. that Curacao in 152, when I did this trip in 152, I just kind of want to expedite the trip a little bit in this area. Only because I kind of have to decide which area of the port I want. that little thing that I just adjusted over there that you can see. That is all that is called DME, which stands for distance measuring equipment. I give you three guesses what that means. If you guess the measures distances, you guess the out. limited our distance to that VOR and never go below 1.0 miles. Why would that be? Any guesses? I'll give you a hint. You're flying 1 mile above the ground. Literally almost exactly. VORs are what they call slant range distance. Well, DME, distance measured for VOR is slant range distance. What that means it takes into account altitude along with distance. It's you know, an angle of a straight line from wherever you are. Part of that distance is directly in the air. Night or you're flying rely solely on your GPS. If for some reason something goes wrong, it could be anything, but it could be just user error. You might have put the wrong information on the GPS. You might not realize that that's the only source of navigation you're using. And you've got all these other, in this airplane, you've got nav radios. You have one, you have two right there. Got the DME to help you, keep track of your distance or wherever it is you're going. And it just adds to the amount of information you have available. Backups and use them. Just smart, just actual final one through. Traffic, Anguilla 264 is clear the runway, Flamingo. And let's see, mixtures are ready for taxi. Let's put the flaps up. Let's turn our landing light off. This is kind of a toggle switch, so you got a landing light main. Just turn the landing light down one notch to turn the fuel pump up. Pull that back one notch to then have your taxi light off. There's a WestJet plane right there. Here you got your United Airlines. Normally I would park to the right of this plane here, which is the exact same plane that I have. But I'm going to park to the left because I want to give you a look at this airport. I paid $11.99 so I could look at this airport. By golly, I'm going to get my $11.99 worth. I don't know when or if I will come back to this airport. I noticed too that the nose of this plane rides around here. See that? Alright, let's go mixtures to idle cutoff. Throttles are at idle. Now let's take a look around here. This is Flamingo Airport. And cool little getting everybody's stuff off the plane. A couple of fire trucks over there. Pretty neat. So that is leg two of our trip around the Caribbean. Let's turn the mags off. Turn all of our lights off. The avionics master off. Turn the master and battery off. And that is that, folks.